Hey everyone, welcome back to our channel. This is a DIY video and in this video I'm going to make a dress. Yeah, so I will be making a dress from a bedsheet. Let me give you a brief of how I came about this idea. There is a very pretty bedsheet which I don't need anymore. It's an old bedsheet. And I was trying to search for some dresses just like that. I don't need any more. I have too many. So I was just doing window shopping. Yeah. So I was just doing window shopping and I came across a very pretty dress. And I thought it looks simple. So if I like, maybe I could try to make it. But I don't know if I could. So here is the dress. As you can see, it has white straps and it's a pretty simple dress. I would try to make this one, and so this is a DIY video. And as you can see in that dress, the neckline is straight, so the one which I'm wearing right now, I would try to make a neckline like this straight. And for straps, this one has a very thin strap, but in that I will try to make a very thick strap. So, and let me show the full dress. As you can see, it's still my knees. Let me keep the camera far. I don't know if you could see. Let me turn it this way. So my plan is to make a dress similar to what I am wearing. Just keep a thick strap. Let me quickly bring the fabric, the bed sheet. I don't know if you could see. So this is a bed sheet. It is a single bed sheet. But what I have planned to do is like, it just has colorful polka dots. So my plan is, I will use this side as a front of my dress, so it will give a very light color, because I think it will be too bright. I don't know. Yeah, I think it will be, this side will look better. So yeah, let's see which side I will use. So stay tuned. I will show all the steps what I'm doing. Let me show you first the blueprint of the dress. Here is the bottom skirt seam. This is the skirt part. This is the waistband. This is bodice. And finally, two straps. So the plan is to first use a circle skirt calculator to cut fabric for the skirt. Then we will create waistband, bodice, and straps. So first I will be making a skirt part. And for that, I have to measure the waist. So my waist is 29.
I have opened a circle skirt calculator. Select inches, half, midi. Give the waist measurement and click on to the math. It will give us the measurements of waist radius and skirt length that we need to cut from the fabric.
So here I have laid the fabric and I will cut out the skirt from here. So this will be the waist part of my skirt, and then I will cut out this hole as the length of the skirt. So like this, and the remaining fabric I will use for the bodice and the straps.
Fold the fabric in half and start marking the waist measurements around the quarter circle. After that, we will do the same for the skirt length. Now we will cut the fabric where we have marked to get the skirt part. Now here I am just stitching the bottom seam of the skirt. So this is how the skirt will look, and now I have to make the upper part. Here I am cutting fabric for the waistband. I wanted the width as 2.5 inches. So I need to cut 5 inches as I will use double fabric for the band and add extra 1 inch for seam allowance. I made this belt. It will go here above the skirt. So now I will attach it. So here I will stitch the skirt top part in this area. Before stitching the waistband to the skirt, I am securing everything with pins. Now it's time to cut fabric for bodice. I had to cut a rectangle of 36 inches by 16 inches. After that, I will fold it in half to make bodice of size 36 inches by 8 inches. Now stitch it and then add darts to the bodice. This is the bodice, and here I have drafted the dart linings like this. This will be the bodice. I will add here darts. Adding dart is super easy and I learned it in 2 minutes only. I will leave a link in description of the video from where I learned it. We just have to first mark a triangle and then fold it in half and then place pin at the pointed corner where you want the dart to end, and then just stitch on the straight line. I have created the bodice. You can see the darts here. So now all I have to do is attach this to the skirt. Before attaching the bodice to skirt, I am securing everything with pins and then carefully stitch it all. I have attached the bodice and this is how it is looking currently. So now I have to stitch the back. I have just secured it with pins right now. I'm very tired today. It's late at night. So the rest of the work I will do tomorrow morning. Good morning. It's the next day. This is the leftover fabric. This is the mess. This is the dress, half-made dress. I will finish it today. And look at this view. So let's go back and do my sleepy face. So I will just now get ready for the day, have some breakfast. I didn't had anything for dinner last night. I was so excited to make the dress that I completed my office work around 7 p.m. I had a meeting at 6:15 and I got free around 7:15, and then
I just started working on this and I got free at 1 a.m. So like 5-6 hours continuously I was working and I didn't even have dinner. So now it's 10 in the morning and I will just have some breakfast and then I will start the video.
This is the breakfast I am doing. It is palak paneer, 2 breads, some black coffee to wake me up, and after that I will have my multivitamins. This is fish oil and this is multigreen and fruits. It's very good. I have these daily. In this video, my voice was not clear, so giving voiceover. Basically, I was just explaining that today I will attach the straps and finish the back portion. Also in back, my plan is to give a little slant as I don't want straight back design. So let's start. To make straps, I am using a belt as a template. Hey guys, so here's the final dress and I had to make a lot of correction in this. Like I had to add extra hole for the button as back was a bit tight for me. So let's wear it. As you can see in the back, I added little bow, so it's just a belt I attached because in the back there were a lot of corrections, so to hide it, and it looks pretty also. And yeah, I'm very happy with how it turned out. If you are making it for the first time like I did, so don't forget to add extra fabric while cutting it so that it won't be very tight. And right now it's perfectly the fitting is perfect for me. It's not very tight, like I'm not feeling anything. So yeah, I'm pretty happy. That's such a massive pimple. I think the camera is focusing on my pimple more. Thank you so much guys for watching this video, and it's the end, and I really enjoyed making this dress. This dress is very special to me as it's the first time I've ever made any dress. And a huge thanks to Hannah because by seeing her video only I was able to figure out how to make a dress. So I will leave a link to her video in the description. Do check that out. So guys, if you watched this video till here, don't forget to like, comment and subscribe. See you in the next video.